Hey guys, today I... Hey guys, yeah, I've been away for a while, but I'm back and ready to continue to cheer you up with cool and unique chemical experiments and to tell you about some really interesting chemicals. So as you might have noticed, there is that very can on my table that interests you all so much, but we'll get back to it later. Thanks to your financial support, I bought a professional mic and professional recorder. This setup will let me record both very loud and very quiet sounds of chemical reactions. It will also help when I'll be getting rid of those noises that the motor of my ventilation hood fan makes. I can even make some kind of chemistry ASMR videos now, like this. All in all, this must boost the quality of the content sufficiently, not to mention it's just wrong to make a video about this chemical reagent without proper sound. By the way, if you want to know, I was using a simple on-camera mic up to this moment. Well, the can. Most of you already know what's inside, but if you don't, here is some unpacking footage for you. Straight to the question of when I'm about to kill myself, of when I'm about to make a video with this super acid. Well, now I have a few videos almost ready to go. I filmed all the material for them a couple of months ago, and I'm also thinking about making a few interesting videos with my new sound setup. And after that, I'll be finally making a video about fluoroantimonic acid, I think. Anyway, I expect that upcoming video to boost the channel's ratings and reputation, so I'm interested in it as much as you are. For now, I think I'll be making a few videos about this chemical. So please share your ideas of reactions with fluoroantimonic acid in the comments. I think you'll have some great suggestions that I'll be able to carry out, like alkylation of benzene with methane, or what will happen if you dip a pH indicator strip in fluoroantimonic acid. With that said, I'll be waiting for your comments, and I hope that this autumn, or at least this year, we'll see what the strongest acid in the world is capable of. But for now, it's still contained behind the steel walls of a can that is hidden in another can behind the walls made of polytetrafluoroethylene. See you in the next video.